Well, for one, I'm finally using my camera and I'm trying to not look in the viewfinder. I'm trying to just make it my business to look in the middle. But it is like 1:45 in the morning and no sleep at all. And I had to get stuck twice this morning because guess what? First, let me make it clear. I love my nurse or whatever, but she had to like redraw all our blood because something went wrong with the blood. I don't know. So everybody had to get their blood redrawn. And yeah, so then I got woken up again. I'm just like, she said, man. I looked up. I'm just like, I might as well just stay up now. I'm up already. So it is all. It's almost, yeah. I told y'all it's almost 7 o'clock shift change, and I'm just gonna stay up because I'm gonna try to go back to sleep. The new nurses are about to come in now. So yeah. Yeah, I lost my phone. I don't even have my phone yet. I lost it. Oh, I'm about to get an x-ray right now, so I'll see y'all. So I'm still trying to get used to this, so y'all just gonna have to bear with me, okay? But I just got a chest x-ray, and I feel like it's kind of dark now. See, now that's light. That's light, okay? Why is it light now? What that kind? Okay. All right. Anyways, whatever. Bye. I probably have to handle it through the legal system. Is there any way I can turn myself in to jail?
You wouldn't be going to jail. We would just send you out paperwork to get your paychecks garnished. And it looks like court proceedings will just begin without you if we can't get you out that paperwork. So that's why I'm trying to confirm the address to send you out this.
Well, the thing is, I can't pay that, and that was in 2009, and so it's just old, and I have to pay for that, and I need a double lung transplant, so, you know, I would appreciate if you don't call my phone no more, just send it to wherever you need to send it to, and they'll get it to me, okay? Because right now, that's the last thing I'm worried about. I'm just worried about two lungs. Right now,
I just want to state, ma'am, in our defense, we did send you out a notice at the beginning of last month for mail. I don't know if you got that or not.
I've been in the hospital a long time now. So gotcha. I haven't got anything. Okay.
Receive your paperwork within the next 2 business days. Are you going to be home by then or are you?
No, I've been in the hospital. I don't know when I'm getting out. I've been here a long time. over 2 months. Okay. So I don't know.
Okay. Do you mind if I get the name of the hospital?
No, I can't give you the name of the hospital where I'm at. Well, you are finished because you know why you're finished? Because I'm finished. So bye. My phone messed with me. I don't know how they get back there, but what you do, you go to block. Yo, they really tried me. Why are you calling me about something that's back in 2009? And then he really pissed me off when he asked what hospital I'm at, because it's like, first off, you're not only gonna bother people, well, I already told you plenty of times that I'm in a hospital, but you're willing to still bother them and deliver paperwork to them while they're in the hospital. That is so very disrespectful, because at this point, nobody is worried about bills, okay? Or what they owe back in 2009. So just get off my phone. He really tried it. He really tried it. And I'm over it, okay? 2009, we're in 2018, okay? That was off my credit, 7 years, okay? It's been 7 years, so it's been off my credit. So why are you worried about it? Let me be great. Anyways, I'm about to try to get on my computer and do some. I am really struggling with this, but I'm gonna have it down within a few days. I'm gonna have me looking in this view thing pretty, you know, down and not up here. And yeah, and I'm gonna have like the settings packed down, what I need to do to get the settings right. So the lighting is gonna be going in and out, cause it's on auto right now. And that's just what we're working with. Hey, we gotta learn, but I haven't ate. Oh God. Well, I actually, y'all are gonna be so proud of me. I requested that they send for breakfast, since I don't eat none of their breakfast and I just eat fruit. I requested that they send a big fruit platter, you know, instead. So I got that and it was really, really good. The fruit on there was really, really good. I only ate the strawberries and grapes. I had my Ensure. I just had some cucumbers. Well, I ordered this salad for lunch, but I'm not gonna eat that. I'm gonna just have a sandwich. But yeah, I'm gonna try to start eating like the fruit every morning. And I have me some bananas right here. My doctor did come by. No news at all. He's just like, we're just waiting. He just was coming to check and make sure that I'm okay. I didn't need anything. So the only thing that really has been bothering me, as you guys know, are my sinuses. Some more of the nasal decongestant and Benadryl. So I'm working with that. I'm so happy because remember I told y'all I was looking for business cards, and my friend was like, you can make that yourself, which I kind of knew, you know, because I kind of just wanted to do my own little thing. That's what I did. That's what I just did. I just made it myself. I can't wait to show you guys me. And I'm very, very proud of myself. I hope that one day, if you don't already, people can see me outside of my sickness, because I have so many talents. I have so much to offer than just, you know, this sickness. And a lot of times that's what, because the last 10 years, I've been sick. I've been on oxygen. So a lot of people recognize me by that, you know? And if I don't have that, a lot of people won't recognize me. And I hope that one day that people will see beyond my sickness and know that I have so much to offer. Very talented in so many areas, and people don't even know it. So yeah, just one day I'll get to show you guys all of my talents. You'll get to see how creative I am and just really how much I have to offer outside of this health stuff. Because this is not, we're not gonna identify ourselves with our condition. We are people. We are people that have a purpose. We are people that have talent. And we are people that have so much more to offer others if they just let us and they just see outside of our conditions. And I think that's the important thing.
I have to tell y'all what happened the other day when my mom came to sign in. So at this hospital, you have to sign in, right? So she goes to sign in. Usually when you sign in, you tell them the name and the room number and they give you a visitor pass. So she goes to sign in and they ask her for her ID this time. And she's like, well, y'all never really asked me for ID before, so why are y'all asking now? And they said, you know, well, we have to start asking for IDs. You know, we have people that's just signing in under crazy names. And they said, see, look. And y'all, guess what? Somebody signed in on a Big Daddy. And they let them in too. Really? Y'all let Big Daddy sign in? I want to know who Big Daddy is. That is so funny. They just let him put his name as Big Daddy. They didn't question it.
No room.
Or anything. So, that is so funny. Guess what, guys? I am getting upgraded to a bigger room now, okay? I'm just so happy that I'm getting upgraded to a bigger room. And I will be in my big room tomorrow. And so we're just gonna, the patient was discharged today, so they're gonna clean it up and just let it air out. And I can move, but it is so big. I can't wait to show y'all how big it is. I'm not sure if I have a view, but all that I know is it's big and it's by the microwave. So if I have any problems with getting to the microwave and back, yeah. I'm just very happy that I get a big room now. My friend was like, now you're gonna try to bring more stuff. I said, no, I'm not. I'm gonna try to keep it at bay with the amount of things I have, but with the bigger room, I'm just able to move around more, and then it'll be comfortable for me and my mom or my guests when they come. So yeah, I'm happy about that. My nurse be talking about me. He was like, yeah, you need to have this stuff packed tomorrow. I'm like, okay. Alright, it's talk time with you guys. I haven't really been vlogging as much because I've been busy. So, let's go ahead and get the talking. Got my little granola bar. Some news about my chest down here. So I got some news about my chest x-ray. It is not, it's showing more stuff, and so we're just trying to see. So what we're gonna do, because my concern is I don't want it to turn into an infection or pneumonia, because it's really gonna set me back. So I can't feel it, and as you guys know, I've been looking like it, and I've been telling you guys how I've been feeling, and it's no joke. And I've been feeling like this a couple of days, so about a few days now. So what we're gonna do, he's gonna start me on a antibiotic called Lovaquin. I'm not allergic to that one, but I am allergic, as you guys always see me in this one, I'm allergic to this one. But we're gonna start on the Lovaquin, and I'm hoping that that helps. But I'm already on an antibiotic, so you know, it's gonna suppress my immune system even more. So I have to be
even more careful. It's so stressful. That's like, I think that's like one of the most stressful things that I guess it's kind of preparing me for after the transplant, because I'll have to be extra careful. So now I have to be more careful, even more careful. And then after transplant, I have to be extra careful. I have to just, oh, see, this is how stuff get lost. They put my pillow in a regular pillowcase. And so I would have probably just been like, okay, my pink cover already got thrown away, because my mom, what she does is she puts it under their covers. So then when they go and change the bed, they just take everything and just, so that's what happened to my pink cover. So yeah, I'm a little upset about that. But hopefully I don't get sick. But whatever it is, hopefully those antibiotics will kill it ahead of time, you know? And then so far, everything else has been good. Have you guys been up to? Tell me, are you liking this camera quality or what? Like, I promise I'm gonna get better at it. I just have to learn it, and I don't know it. So y'all gonna have to work with me a few vlogs. But after a few with this camera, I should be able to pretty much get it packed down. Okay, nothing else is going on. I just feel like so much is going on. I haven't really, you know what, let me see any word about a counselor, because my head is still hurting and my caseworker hasn't called me back about my counselor.
3 is full and cannot accept new messages at this time. Please try again later. Goodbye.
All right, it's not even accepting messages, but it's after 5, so she's probably off. But I have to set a reminder to call her first thing in the morning, because she was supposed to be seeing what resources there were for me to either talk to a therapist over the phone or to see a therapist. So I'm waiting for her to do that. I think that would really be beneficial, because my head is hurting, y'all. I wanted to ask you guys, give me one thing that actually keeps you going, that makes you actually say, I want to fight another day. You don't have to be sick, but going through something.
Yes. Vitals.
I had to get my vitals checked. I'll be back. So like I was saying, what is it that just makes you want to continue on to the next day? A lot of you are not sick. A lot of you are. You know, have your own things that you're dealing with. It could be depression. It could be anxiety. It could be, you know, you having a rough home life, or you're going through something in your marriage, or just something. You're struggling with something. That's the thing. We're all struggling with something. So what makes you just say, still, God, wake me up tomorrow? And what makes you just want to continue? And I'm going to answer that for you guys. It makes me want to continue on and just say, I'm going to fight this. I want to make it to the next day. God, wake me up. Is, I know if I fight, if I do what I need to do and I do my best that I can do, and I fight, my thing is, I'm gonna fight to the end. I don't see myself giving up. I don't see myself ever just saying that I'm done with life. Because if I wake up another day, that means that I have a purpose for that day. It's some purpose in that day for me. So God woke me up. He saw me, all about me enough to wake me up that day. So I can't give up. I can't. What else keeps me going is just, I know that, and I've always said it, but this is what keeps me going, is I know that when I fight, and I fight, and I fight, it's something amazing is gonna come from this, because I fought. I stayed true to myself. I stayed true to my faith. I stayed true to God. So at the end of the day, I know that I'm gonna be okay. Yes, I'm gonna have my up days. Yes, I'm gonna have my down days. Yes, I'm gonna have days where I feel like, hey, yes, I'm gonna have days where I feel like I don't wanna be here at the hospital no more. I'm gonna have those days, and that's because I'm human. But when it's all said and done, I'm gonna fight like there's no tomorrow each day. I'm gonna fight. Just let me know what keeps you going to say, hey, I want to make it to that next day. Thank you, God, for waking me up today. Please wake me up tomorrow. Because, you know, it's different for everybody. We're all fighting for something. Me right now, what I'm fighting for is I'm just fighting for strength. And I'm fighting to be well enough to get this lung transplant and to go through this surgery and to be healthy. Again, you know, of course, I'm always gonna be on medicine and all of that good stuff, but you know, I could be healthy for 6 months and be okay with that. That's what keeps me going, is that I know something so amazing is gonna come from it all. God causes all things to work together for good. And that's not just a saying, He does. So, me going, and it is 5:25. It's 5:25. I don't really have much else to say, so I'm gonna go ahead and end this vlog, do my diary, edit, and I will see you guys tomorrow. For looking up and down and up and down, but I'm gonna get it together, okay? I'm trying. Please, tomorrow. If I don't get the call tonight. At times, we can feel like, why? Why are we even fighting so hard? So I have to ask myself today, Asha, why are you fighting so hard? I fought, and I fought. I'm fighting because life is beautiful. I'm fighting because I have a purpose. I'm fighting because God allowed me another day. And any day that He wakes me up, thankful. God, please strengthen my desire to keep fighting. Allow more fighting. And allow me to inspire others who are about to stop fighting or thinking about giving up their fight. God, I want to thank you for today, every day.